It's time for madness, our favorite month, right? Woo!
Absolutely.
Basketball. So in addition to doing that really awesome bracket where you can win a LulzBot, if you have not already entered, sorry, it closed, the games have started. We've also been working on this really, really cool basketball hoop. Ta-da! So it's got a sensor, it counts your hoops, displays it, and lights. So the first challenge was actually getting the sensor to read consistently, not miss any, and not duplicate. You were all over that.
Yep, we had a few different options. The first one we actually thought about was using a limit switch as opposed to a sensor, an infrared sensor. So we 3D printed some little devices to actually capture when the ball would hit this.
Fly swatter.
It would detect, or yeah, fly swatter. Phase one, too heavy. So it needs to actually drop down and go back up. Phase two worked better, but as the ball would hit it, it would just bounce a bunch of times and basically give people like 5 points as opposed to one. So not ideal. So then we moved into working with an infrared sensor that's going to detect on how much light gets back. So not actually touching the basketball at all. And tried that in a few different locations. Best ended up being a 3D printed ring at the base of the hoop. The neat thing about using an IR sensor is that we actually decided to use that to control everything with this. So rather than having a separate push button to initialize the game to begin with, we decided to just trigger everything off of the IR. So when someone wants to start the game, they actually just shoot, make their first basket, and it's gonna count, and then keep counting down for them.
Exactly. And another neat programming effect that got thrown in there was that the color does change as the clock starts to decrease. So once it gets on 20 seconds, you see it go yellow, both on the screen and the NeoPixels, and then at 10 seconds, it goes red. We also, you can see, have beautiful diffusion on the backboard here, and that is a huge shout out to LulzBot and the TAS 5. That is all 3D printed with a clear material, and it worked beautifully. It works really nicely, and that's only, what, a 16th of an inch thick? Mm-hmm. It doesn't have to be a long print to get really nice custom diffusers off of that. We were also pretty worried about that beautiful LED matrix you see going on behind the screen because it's fragile, right? And a lot of people slam it against the backboard. So far, it's not had any issues. LEDs themselves are pretty rigid. We were just worried about the circuitry against the back, so you cut out some nice custom foam padding. So it's actually missing one pixel all the way around because we padded it with foam, which was not actually that difficult to do. This is one of the 32 by 64 pixel arrays from Adafruit, and it works like a charm. It was a little bit difficult to get everything working the first time because we were using an Uno, and it turns out it needs the RAM of a Mega. So if you're trying to do that, don't mess with it. You really do need an Arduino Mega to run this thing. And once we got all that figured out, we were able to write the code and get it moving. The delays were very exciting because it counts down from 30 seconds and needs to simultaneously read the sensor and update the lights and update the screen. So it's really hard to do all that with just interrupts and get consistent 1 second countdowns, mm-hmm. which turns out people notice when 1 second is like five times longer than the other ones. So that's a very clever arrangement of small delays that are built into if-else statements and turns out to be exactly 1 second. We're pretty proud of being able to count to 60 seconds. Mm-hmm. And we also have the NeoPixels from Adafruit all over it, making beautiful, beautiful lights. And you can see going on behind us, it just turned from yellow to red. So, colors. You want to play with it?